Well, it turns out Meghan Markle has made quite a few changes now she's officially part of the royal family. But has the new royal taken her princess lessons a little too far? A video featuring the Duchess speaking in a rather posh, almost British accent has gone viral on social media, leaving people baffled. Have a listen.
Thank you, I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
Hi, it's nice to meet you.
You too, it's me.
My name's Aya.
Aya.
I have been a fan of you for so long.
Was that?
I was you for so long.
I was you too.
I don't know about that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I couldn't beat up.
Yeah, a little bit. I think that's scratching the barrel, shall we say?
Is bottom it? Off?
Yeah,
bottom,
I think so.
Bottom off?
But
I don't know. What are your thoughts?
Look, yeah. I actually just think that's the way you would speak when you're in a very important position now. So it's not, I don't think she's bunging on an accent.
Yeah.
I don't think she's an actress who's going, I'm now playing the role of a royal. I think you just would be polite in that situation, and that's how her voice would sound.
I wonder, Breenie, if you think that, you know, after some time, when you spend some time with people speaking in a different accent, you
take on that accent?
You start to move into that territory. You kind of smooth out the edges.
Did it happen to you?
A little
bit,
yeah.
When you were overseas for a long time?
Because when I lived in America, I had to start saying Peter. Because if I ordered something and I'd say Peter, they go, what? David?
What?
What? David? You know? So every time I ordered something, I had to go Peter. And I felt like an idiot.
I think Meghan, she's not trying too hard, but she's trying.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I think she's trying to not make any slip-ups. She's going along that line, talking to people, quite a formal way. Like, if I'm going to meet the Prime Minister, I'm not going to say, what's doing, Mal?
Why not? Why not?
Oh, because I think in that circumstance...
Yeah.
Respect.
You know what I mean?
Respect.
Yeah.
What's I don't know.
We've probably covered
that. But is she trying? Is she trying a little bit too hard, though?
No, I think she's amazing, and I think everyone needs to leave Meghan alone. I love her.
But I watched the whole thing. If you look at the whole... Like, it goes for a couple of minutes.
Yeah.
Forever.
No, I think she gets away with
that.
But it might be a little shot across the bow. Yeah. A little warning shot.
Hey, another story that's caught our eye this morning. Whitsunday's MP Jason Costigan has been dubbed a sleazebag by Queensland's Deputy Premier Jackie Trad after he posted a video and images on Facebook celebrating World Bikini Day with young foreign tourists in bikinis. So she's taken to Twitter, she's caught him out, asking him, did you get a good look?
Looks like he's having a gander.
Is it? He's having a good look, isn't he?
Yeah. look, I think
that's the sound of your argument leaving the room.
I think Jackie Trad's out of line here. Like her language is over the top.
Sleazebag.
Yeah, and I think he's an MP from the Whitsundays who's trying to use a gimmick to promote his area. Now, politicians are famous for gimmicks the world over, right? And I don't think the two females there didn't want to be in a photo in their bikinis in the middle of winter in the Whitsundays. Mm.
And also, that might just be one of those freeze frames. It's a bit unfortunate.
The thing is, politicians are famous for gimmicks. They're also famous for gaffes. I would call this a gaffe. I would say, you know what? Be a little bit more in tune with what's happening in society at the moment. Don't put yourself in between the bikini girls. Like, you can say, you know, promote the Whitsundays with bikini girls, but not actually be the guy who's
in the middle of it.
Probably thinks that's a perk of the job.
Well, that in itself is an issue, thank
you. Do you think Jackie Trad's language is over the top,
I agree with you. I think that she's gone too far, but I would just say to him, just think.
She should have said, dude, what's doing?
What's doing?
And just left it at that. Then everyone else could have sorted it out.
Like, why wouldn't you promote the Whitsundays? What a beautiful part
of
the world. Okay, the Baby Blues are gearing up for Origin 3, hoping for a clean sweep in Brisbane on Wednesday night. But in a first, New South Wales Rugby League has been secretly filming every moment of the Origin build-up with hopes of turning it into an historic film. What, because they won one series? Greeny.
It was an historic moment.
Okay, now, well, what do you think us Queenslanders would say?
Because he won one series.
Yeah, they're going to bang. Yeah. You know what? And I, in my day job, I cover the Blues, you know, for this intense 5-6 week period.
Yeah.
I'm not that interested to watch it.
No.
What is it going to be? Selection meetings and this and... And the other thing is, I don't think it'll be... actually warts and all.
Yeah.
Because
edited.
If they filmed 100 hours, there would have been a lot of secrets in there, thoughts on selections, how to play Queensland, how to do this to this bloke or that bloke, the other bloke. They're not going to put that in the film.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
don't know that.
What are you they won't put they it in the film.
Will you watch it?
They won't.
Look, I am a true blue Queenslander, so I don't really.
Hang on, what does that mean?
True blue. That was a bit weird.
Convicted.
One of those tautologies.
I'm not that interested in the rugby league, but I've got to say, as someone who's not really part of it, I think that Freddie Fittler's doing a really good job, and if this is just another thing that's promoting that he's doing a good job, I'm actually not against it.
I'm on board.
I like Brad Fittler. He's a nice guy.
I don't know about this, like, grounding yourself by putting your feet in the grass, but it's working.
Just quickly, Wednesday night?
Queensland.
Billy Slater's last game. They have to win for him.
Yeah.
You know what? Don't you always think it's a bit of a downer though when New South Wales won the series, and then they lose the.
And if they lose the last game, New South Wales, then they've got to go on the field and be presented with the trophy. I think that's a farce.
Yeah.
When you win the trophy, no matter what that's going to, you should get it.
Yeah. Mm. Good one, Brandon.
Like no one's going to hang around at Suncorp and go, "Well done, Boyd Cordner."
Yeah.
You know, are they? Seriously.
All right. Thank you, guys. Coming up next, the kids taking the Ninja.